It's America's greatest pastime, and across Rhode Island, bats are swinging and pitches are being thrown. It's baseball season. But today's starting lineups have a great legacy behind them to thank for that, including Providence's own Brown University. And joining me to tell us more about the history behind that is historian Rick Harris, whose book recounts these stories. Good morning, Rick.
Good morning, Michaela.
All right, so I want to start off with the history of baseball at Brown University. When did this actually happen?
Well, we first pick up baseball on Brown University in 1827 mm-hmm. in a student's diary, William Latham, and he writes two entries that year playing baseball in the commons. And the real significance of that is the fourth oldest written history in the country of baseball.
Wow.
The first is 1791 in Pittsfield, Massachusetts. The second is 1823 in New York City. And the third is another game in upstate New York in 1825. And then we have Brown.
Wow, so definitely a big part of baseball history at Brown. Now, like you said, this is all about stories in your book, but it's also about the players. And a lot of the players made it onto the major leagues.
That's right. Altogether, there were 40 players that played for Brown that went on to the major leagues. And most of them were prior to the 1930s, and then we, of course, have the Elopes later on.
Mm-hmm.
But and they made a huge, significant contribution, especially in the 1890s and early 1900s.
Wow, that's amazing. Now, another thing that I found interesting was, of course, you know, the pictures in your book are stunning. And almost, I was laughing at some of the old uniforms that you feature, of course. And talk about your research that went behind. 9 years, you were saying you were working on this.
Yes, I mean, I do have a day job. So this 9 years is a lot of late afternoons and vacation time. Mm-hmm. It's been at the Brown Archives, the John Hay Library. It took me 8 years to build a database to prepare for writing this book. That's 97 pages long. It has every game, every pitcher, every field, every player that played for Brown from about 1827 to 1943.
A lot of research behind that. Now, another thing you said was that baseball is more than just a game. You call it a social construct.
That's
Why
right.
is that? Explain more.
Well, humans need to have activity. They need to have structure in their lives mm-hmm. other than work. That's important too. However, baseball has been a magnet for people coming from all walks of life and gathering in the same place. As a professional social worker, that's how I recognize it. And so baseball is a game, but it's also a construct that we invent as humans, so that we can get together and do something else than what our day jobs are.
Mm-hmm. Wow, it's all so interesting. Now, if you want to pick up a copy of his book, of course, it's Brown University Baseball, A Legacy of the Game. You can learn more about the history of Brown baseball and meet Rick at his upcoming book signing. It's tomorrow at the Brown University Bookstore. We'll put all of the details on our website, WPRI.com.